हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ लोहित दलाल, लेक्चरर इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड कम्युनिकेशन इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट, जैन पॉलिटेक्निक बेलगावी। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस यूनिट नंबर 4, ऑर्गेनाइजेशनल सेफ्टी। ओके, इन दिस लेक्चर आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस रिगार्डिंग सेफ्टी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एंड देयर इज द ड्यूटीज ऑफ सेफ्टी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन और सेफ्टी इंस्पेक्टर, सेफ्टी सुपरवाइजर, जनरल सेफ्टी रूल्स टू बी डिस्कस्ड हियर। नेक्स्ट, safety organization, it mainly consists of what? Safety manager, safety engineer, safety supervisor, inspector and workers. Okay, so there will be a safety organization will display the safety banners. Okay, it contains what? Precautions or rules to be followed. Okay, and also the safety management will also display the video films about the safety at the workplaces and how to use safety equipments to the workers at the end of the month. Okay, and also there will be some structure of the safety organization. Okay, safest organization having some structure. So safety engineers will visit the factory, okay, and give the useful information or instructions periodically about the safety, right? The safety team will give the guidelines and training to the workers regarding to the safety. Okay, so and also there is a safety organizations. In a safety organization, they are displaying the banners containing the precautions, rules to be followed by employees at every working places. It conducts the what? Safety exhibitions, and awards will be given to the those workers who work safety without meeting the any accidents and creating the safety awareness among the workers. And also safety management will also display the video films about the safety at the workplaces. They are displaying the LEDs, okay, continuously they are displaying how to use the safety equipments to the workers, and at the end of the each month they are going to train how equipments to be used, how the machineries to be used. Okay, that is the structure of the organization. So next, there will be a duties of safety inspector. So first one, he should be capable of providing the first aid treatment to the injured person. Okay, safety inspector have to provide first aid treatment to the injured person. Next, he should advise supervisory staff regarding safety practices, and also he maintain accident reports submitted by the supervisor and details of the injured records. Okay, and also the management about unsafe practices in the industry, that should be recommended by the safety inspector. And also he has to estimate the dangerous amount, okay, amount of danger involved in the due to an accident. Okay, and also he has to make the safety methods, how to make safer for the employees. Safety, he has to incorporate the safety, and also he has to make the what? Proper arrangement to shift injured person from injured person to the nearest hospital. And also he must prepare an accident report at the spot itself only. Okay, those are the duties of safety inspector. Next, there is a duties of safety supervisor. Okay, so safety supervisor, he should provide necessary training to the workers about safety methods. He should advise inspection staff regarding safety practices. Okay, and also he should maintain accident reports submitted by the inspector and details of the injury of the records. Okay, so he should recommend it to the management about unsafe practices in the industry. He should estimate amount of the dangers involved to an accident. He should incorporate safety methods, and also okay, so means safety supervisor has to recommend the management to unsafe practices, and also he should estimate the amount of cost involved in the accident. He should incorporate safety methods. He should display safety posters up and appropriate places, right? So these are the duties of the safety supervisors. Okay, and also some general safety rules will be there. First one, there is a fencing of machinery. Fencing of machinery means every moving part of a prime mover or of every flywheel, okay, or you can take it as a head race and a tail race of every water. Okay, that is a fencing machineries. Okay, so that should be properly safeguarded, right? So every part of an electric generator, a motor or rotary converter, every part of a transmission machinery and dangerous parts and other machineries, those are properly handled. So next one, work on a near machinery in a motion. Okay, the machine is rotating. Moving machinery shall be done by specially trained adults or a male workers only. So next one, casing of the machineries. In this, all the machine drives are driven by the power installed in the factory. After the commencement of this act, every set screw, bolt or any keys, okay, so that it should be perfectly fixed, perfectly installed, okay, in order to avoid the accidents. Next one, hoist and lifts. Okay, so every hoist and lifts shall be good mechanical construction and of the adequate strength. They shall be properly maintained and truly examined, right, in a regularly, okay, regular. So it should need it shall be marked with a sufficient, with a maximum safe working load. So in every hoistway and a liftway shall be what, sufficiently protected by an enclosure fitted with the gates. So next one, lifting machines, chains, ropes and lifting tackles. So all parts including the working gears, lifting machines, chains, ropes or lifting tackles shall be good condition or a good construction and of adequate strength, properly maintained and truly examined at least once in every period of 12 months. Lifting machine means a crane, grab, winch, pulley and block, etc. Okay, so revolving machinery means a notice shall be affixed to every grinder indicating the maximum safe working peripheral speed of the every grindstone or a abrasive wheel. The speed of the shaft or a spindle upon the wheel is mounted. So next one, excessive. Okay, so means correct weight or correct machinery is to be lifted. Okay, so means there is some amount of, okay, excessive weight means no person shall be employed in a factory to lift, carry or move any load heavy as to be likely causes to the injury. So state government has made some rules, okay, describing what maximum weight which may be lifted or carried by an adult man or adult woman. Okay, so next one, in this session we have discussed safety organization. Okay, that is a structure of safety organization, how the safety organization becomes, okay, and also duties of the safety inspector and the safety supervisors and some general safety rules we have discussed. Thank you.